promised land.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
For those to whom much is given, much is required.
Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Seek, and ye shall find. Ask, and it shall be given.
And the will of God is in heaven, even so let him do.
God is our refuge and strength.
The most powerful story of all time continues to shape our world. It's the foundation of our governments, the blueprint for our laws, a sacred guide for life's journey. This is the Bible.
God warned me. He told me to build a boat.
God has spoken to me.
He will lead us to a new home. He has promised descendants as numerous as the stars.
Who are you?
My name is Moses.
God has sent me to set you free.
The Lord brought us out from Egypt, promised us this land. Soon, it will be ours.
Jerusalem, our new home.
David, you have forged God's nation on earth.
A nation that the people find faith in an all-powerful creator.
God is with me!
Their story helps define who we are.
Lord.
The choices we make. How we live. How we love. How we struggle and overcome.
Who created the earth? Sea? Sky? Who created you?
Jerusalem,
help yourselves!
It's a trap for all of us. They want us dead.
God is bringing disaster from Babylon!
Lady, I believe your son is the promised king of his people. What is his name?
Jesus. His name is Jesus.
You said there was trouble.
The people are flocking to this wild man, John. They think he's a prophet. Some even call him the Messiah.
There is one to come who will baptize with fire. I am just a voice in the wilderness preparing the way for the...
Lord, what are we going to do?
Change the world.
Who?
Jesus! He's back at last!
Blessed are the poor, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth.
What are you saying? That you are the Messiah, the chosen one, sent by God?
It has begun.
Your hunger for righteousness will be filled through me.
5,000 came to see. 5,000.
Your king comes to you riding on a donkey.
There is something unusual about him.
There is nothing unusual about him apart from his ability to cause havoc.
If the disturbances that took place today are repeated, I will crush any rebellion.
Beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. Then God separated the water and the sky. He formed the seas and the land.
covered the land with trees and plants. Then he filled the world with all the creatures of the sea. Of the air. And all the creatures of the ground. And then he made us. To live in paradise. Until Adam and Eve disobeyed God and ate the forbidden fruit. And with one choice, they learned both good and evil. Since Cain killed Abel, God has seen too much evil in human hearts. Wrong choices, wrong decisions. That's why this has happened. Our Creator decided to cleanse the earth. God warned me. He told me to build a boat. A boat to save our family and all the animals. Every other living creature would die. And on the seventh day, God rested.
After the floodwaters engulfed the world, the Bible describes a new beginning for Noah's descendants and a chance to restore the relationship between God and humanity. A new faith in an all-powerful Creator is being born. But before billions can believe in him, one man must hear God's voice and have the faith to follow.
Abraham, leave your home and go to the land I will give to you and your offspring. I will bless you. I will make you a father of many nations, with descendants as numerous as the stars. All the peoples on earth will be blessed through you.
Sarah, God has spoken to me. Come with me.
Lot, my nephew. Walk with us.
Abraham?
He will lead us to a new home.
But we have a home. A good home.
Away from the city, to a new land. For our children.
But you have no children. You can never have children.
But we will. He has promised descendants as numerous as the stars.
He spoke to me. He promised. Sarah, believe me. Believe me. And Lot, you are with me? He will lead us to a land of wonder.
No. No.
Such wonder!
Driven by the belief that he will father a great nation, Abraham leads his small tribe to the land promised to him by God.
What we decided.
What's going on? His men are trying to take our pasture.
God gave us this land to share.
Then he should have given us more of it. Tell him.
Abraham, there just isn't enough land. There are too many of us.
The Lord will provide. Have faith.
In a God we cannot see.
It's time we go our separate ways.
No. No, we must stay together.
Stay and starve. Stay and watch our men kill each other over a blade of grass.
Uncle. We're leaving.
Very well. Where do you want to go?
To the greener pasture just closer to Sodom.
Sodom?
With no children of his own, Abraham's nephew Lot is the closest thing he has to a son.
How can I lead a people when I can't even lead my own family?
So many of them.
And Lot?
Alive. But taken prisoner.
Help him.
Here. Take my hand. Lean on me. That's better. Tend to him.
We have trained men.
Abraham, you are not soldiers.
I told them to trust in God. I made Lot come with us.
And then they left us. They had their pick of the land. It was their choice.
They are family. We have to help them. God will take care of us. Against so many. God is with us.
Abraham,
we're carrying on to Sodom.
Lord, we must stay together.
Uncle. We have to carry on.
Let's go.
The stars will give us as many descendants to populate our land. He has promised you will have a child.
I won't.
You will.
I won't. I can't. It's too late for me.
For you, there's still a chance.
Hagar, the servant girl.
No.
Yes.
Hold it steady, Ishmael.
Sarah, did you see that? Oh, my boy.
My boy.
Your boy.
Get with your mother.
Abraham.
Please, join me. Bring water. Prepare food for our visitors.
Yes, Master.
Have you traveled far?
Yes, a long way. Abraham, where is your wife? In there.
Next year, Sarah will have a son. Why do you laugh? Did. And when you have a son, you will name him Isaac, which means laughter.
Thank you for your hospitality. We must go.
Can I help you on your way? Where are you going?
To decide the fate of Sodom.
Get out of here!
Sodom has become corrupt, a city of sin.
But my nephew Lot lives there. He has a family.
The outcry against Sodom is great. Its sins are very grave.
You're going to destroy it? The whole city? You are a just God. Will you destroy good men, along with the evil ones?
Please! Help! Help us! Help!
What if there were 50 good people in Sodom? Will they suffer the same fate as the wicked?
Please! Help us!
We will test them. If my angels find 50 righteous people in Sodom, I will spare the whole city.
Please, help us.
They went this way!
Help us.
Or fewer. 30? 20? You would not destroy them, surely.
Please!
Down there!
Help us. This way, sir.
What if there were 10 righteous men in Sodom? Would you not save them?
Lot, what are you doing? Who are these people?
They need our help. I'll do what I can for you.
Even if I find only 10, I will save the whole city.
This way!
Hurry!
What's that?
Open the door!
Not! Not!
Give us the strangers!
Save them to us! Take them out!
They are guests in my house.
They just left! Let them be!
Take you to!
Yeah!
must get away. The city is being punished.
Come on!
Do not look back at the city of sin.
Okay.
Believe in God. Do not look back.
Lord.
Disobeying God. Lot and his daughters flee to the mountains, never to see Abraham again.
How is she?
Ishmael.
Ishmael.
Come on! I am! Hurry!
Good. What's the matter?
That woman thinks her boy is going to inherit what rightfully belongs to Isaac.
What do you mean?
Who is to be the first of all our tribe, Abraham? The first star of all those stars in the heavens. Our son. Or hers.
Sarah.
Abraham. Abraham. You decide. Or let God decide. Be brave.
Assured by God that they will survive, Abraham sends Hagar and Ishmael into the wilderness.
Goodbye, Ishmael. Oh, my boy. My boy. When you grow up, God will bless you with many children.
Let me make you some breakfast, Isaac.
After years of struggle, Abraham has learned that to be chosen by God is a blessing and a test. He must prove his faith again and again.
Faith. Isaac.
Eat up. When you have children of your own, you'll want them to grow up as big and Abraham.
What's the matter?
God wants a sacrifice. My boy, come with me.
Father, we have the firewood, but where's the lamb?
The Lord will provide a sacrifice, my son.
Did Abraham take a lamb?
No, mistress.
Oh,
bring the wood. Isaac, you must trust in God. Abraham!
Abraham has passed the ultimate test. He will become the father of God's nation. Now it's up to Isaac. He will have a son called Jacob. God will rename him Israel. The promise of descendants as numerous as the stars is coming true. But famine forces the Israelites far from the promised land, to Egypt. Here they are enslaved by Pharaoh. Abraham and God become a distant memory. All his people reduced to beasts of burden, except one.
Moses.
Next time on The Bible.
You're not going to fight again.
I can't refuse. He's Pharaoh's son.
Fight me! I order you! You're not one of us!
What's he talking about?
You were born a slave.
Your people are out there, Moses. The Israelites.
Welcome to your new life, Moses! You are nothing now!
You are the God of Abraham.
I will do it. I will set my people free. So much suffering.
Wait, please.
Who are you? My name is Moses. Joshua.
God has sent me to
to set you free.
Why are you here, Moses?
Let my people go.
Freedom! They're free to choose! Slavery or death!
All my life, I have been Pharaoh's. I will never be a slave again.
Joshua, God is with them.
The angel of death is coming.
Go and leave my land and take your wretched God with you!
Moses!